What's up, YouTube? It's Junkie, and I'm back for a late night Junkie Talk video where I give you my thoughts and opinions on something I've been thinking about for a while. And I've had people ask me privately through Instagram my thoughts on certain things and how I deal with certain things here on YouTube. So I figured I was doing a little organizing. And I'm going to take a little bit of a break and kind of give you my thoughts on why I do certain things, how I deal with certain things, and just my thoughts on, like, trolls and friends on YouTube and just different things that go on. So first, I'm sure all of us deal with it at one point or another, are trolls on YouTube. You know, back in the day, we used to say if you got thumbs down or trolls, it's because you were doing good on YouTube. So, when I started in, I want to say September of 2014, I believe, is when I started YouTube. So, just over 5 years ago, I remember getting that first thumbs down, and I remember feeling devastated, you know, because you're like, you know, I put all this work into a video, and I never really did a lot of editing or anything like that, and I just remember getting my first thumbs down, and I just remember, like, wanting to quit YouTube, because I was like, oh, God, how can somebody hate, you know, dislike my video? But, you know, people dislike videos for many things, for many reasons. One, just being assholes. Two, maybe they just didn't like the content of the video. And that could be from anything from you strayed from your normal content. Like, let's say you make videos about comics and then you put up a video about movies or video games or like an out and about video or a cooking video or something like that. And someone just got upset and they thumbs it down because it's not their normal content they were used to. So it's really hard to kind of look at that as constructive criticism. Because usually when people leave a thumbs down, there's never a comment that goes along with it. Like, hey, you know, I didn't like this video because blah, blah, blah. And a lot of times people thumbs down videos for me just to be an asshole. Okay, so along with that comes, you know, you get your trolls, and I've had, over my 5 years on YouTube, I've had so many trolls. Like, maybe at the end of this video, nah, I won't do that, but there, you can, when you block somebody from your channel, which I've blocked quite a few people on my YouTube channel, just because they're repeat offenders, they come back, they make really, just really mean and bizarre comments. Like, you're like, what the fuck does that even mean, or why would you even say that? And it's just like, you know, if you don't like somebody's content, just move on, you know what I mean? But I understand that there are people out there that, you know, that do thumbs down videos of people they just don't like. I've been guilty of it myself in the past, and I've kind of gone away from that type of behavior, because it's easy to get caught up into the moment and just be like, oh, I hate this, or I really dislike this YouTuber, and I'm just going to go thumbs down all their videos. I've done that in the past. And then I realize as it starts happening more and more to you, you realize that it's not the right thing to do. Just unsubscribe them and move on. And just move on, you know? But I've gotten some really bizarre comments. And for the most time, if it's an average hate video, like, hey, you know, I just don't like your content or whatever, for the most part, I'll leave it up. But if it's something, like, really rude or, really out there, I'll delete it. And I'll just report the person. Or block them. Not report them, but block them. And, just because, you know, what you can do is you can always check somebody. Whenever somebody leaves a rude comment, you can check their channel. And usually if they don't have any content, it's somebody, A, that just doesn't have content and they're just out being an asshole. Or B, it's somebody you know and they have, like, what they call a troll channel. And it's a channel that just leaves negative comments because they have no content. They have no videos. They're not subscribed to anybody. They don't have any liked videos or anything like that. Now, there are channels out there that don't have any videos, and there's people out there that just like to watch videos, and they don't want to produce content. And I have a few followers that have followed me for quite a while that are like that. They have channels, and they're legit. They're legit people. They just don't create any content, but they use that channel to, like, socialize and to watch other YouTubers they like, and that's cool. I mean, I understand, because it's hard to get on YouTube and make videos. It's not easy. I know everybody goes through the YouTube jitters when they first start making videos, like, do I look like an idiot? Do I sound like an idiot? You know, just the normal, are people gonna like the content I put out? And it doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be about comics. It could be about anything. It could be about cooking. It could be about video games, action figures, statues, cards, baseball cards, Pokemon cards. So it's hard to get on YouTube and make videos. But getting back to my subject about trolls, it seems like my channel goes through, like, phases. I'll go through a phase where I'll pump out a lot of content, and I'll get a ton of thumbs down. And by, I mean, a ton of thumbs down, like 4 or 5, maybe 6 or 7. It just depends on what I talk about, and I'll get a lot of rude comments. And then that'll happen for, like, a month, maybe 2 months, and then it'll stop. And then I'll put out content, and for, like, 2-3 months, I'll get no thumbs down. A lot of interaction, and then all of a sudden it'll just start right back up again. And I haven't really figured out what the trigger for that is. Usually a certain type of video will spark that, and I haven't figured out what on my channel what it is. It's just random acts of, you know, just meanness. Like the other night, this is it's Sunday morning about 2 a.m. when I'm making this video, so I would say probably Friday night, I just got a rash of thumbs down and some pretty rude comments that I deleted, because it's not something I want to have on my channel. Generally, I'm not one for censorship or hiding someone's opinion. If it's a legit argument, or if it's a legit complaint, I'll leave it up. You know, like, hey, you know, I just don't like this type of video from you. And they'll leave a thumbs down, and they'll tell me why. And that's cool, I understand, so I'll leave that comment up. But it's the mean shit that just irritates the hell out of me. Like the other night, I got a couple comments that they wished I would die. They hate my voice. Oh, what else? They don't like the way I look because I'm fat. It was just really mean that I suck dick to get comics or whatever. It's just really mean comments like that that I deleted, because it's like, there's no point in having that up on my channel. And it's usually from people that were probably subscribers of yours at one time, and you may have done something to offend them or something like that, and they just come back just to leave negative comments. But yeah, stuff like that. And it just started up the other night, and it went on for like 2 days, and I just deleted them. And they're like, oh, you censor, you're deleting my comments, and you're insecure because you hide your thumbs up and thumbs down, and stuff like that. I some of them were held back by YouTube. It wasn't even me, for the content of their comments. It was automatically held back by YouTube. It wasn't even done by me. So it was a comment that needed to be reviewed by me in order to post, and I just went ahead and deleted it. But I tend to get those a lot. There was one a while back that said all my comic book boxes were empty. And at the time, I just thought it was stupid, and it was something I didn't want on my channel, so I deleted it. Even though it wasn't really that bad, it still kind of hit a nerve with me, so I just deleted it. So if you look at some older videos of mine, I'll make comments like, yep, I'm just checking these boxes to show you guys that there's comics in them. And I've had some YouTubers, joke around with me like, hey, check this box over here. I want to make sure there's comics in it. So that's where those jokes and those types of comments come from, is because somebody actually thought that all these comic book boxes in my room were empty. So I thought it was kind of funny. At the time, it offended me, so I deleted it. And, it's your channel. You can put up any kind of content you want. And if people don't like it, then screw them. They don't have to watch it. So that's my ordeal with trolls. You got to kind of have a little bit of thick skin. But sometimes it's hard, because we are still all human beings at the end of the day. And we don't like negative comments. We don't like, we just don't like negativity in general. And, and I'm not going to sit here and be a hypocrite and say that I'm perfect, because I'm not. I've done some stupid shit on YouTube. I've done some things that I regret on YouTube. And if I could take it all back, I would. And my channel would probably be in a different direction. It would have gone a different direction than it is now. I'm sitting at like 20... I want to say just under 2,400, or just over 2,400 subs. And if you look at your analytics, you can see how many subs you've gained, how many subs you've lost. And I've lost probably about 2,000 subs over the years, that if people have come and gone. And you look at that and you think about it, and you're like, damn, that's a lot. That's basically my whole channel worth of subs I've lost. And it's hard. It's a hard pill to swallow, because I'm the type of person where I'm not too sympathetic, and I speak what I want to speak, and I say what I want to say, and whether it offends people or not, that's not my problem. That's yours. And that's generally how I've been, just because for most of my life, I've pretty much been on my own, and that's just how I am. If you don't like me, fuck it, you don't like me. If you do like me, that's great. I'm the type of person to where either you love me or you hate me. There's really not an in-between with me. Do I have my faults? Yes. Do I have my faults? Did I make some mistakes in the past? Yes, and I admit to them. I've thumbs down videos. I've made stupid comments. So a lot of the stuff that I see that happens to my channel now, I just see as karma. And, I say to myself, well, hey, this is what I get. I'll just delete the comment, block the person, and move on. I've made comments about, just stupid stuff, like stay in the kitchen and make a sandwich. I didn't mean that comment towards all women. there were a couple channels that were I've gotten into a heated battle with, and just a couple of them happened to be women channels, and I've made a stupid comment, and I regret it 100%, but I didn't mean it the way that was directed towards all women. It was just those particular two, because they didn't work, and they were just, you know, it was just a back and forth thing, and I regret it, and I lost a ton of subs over it, and I manned up to it, and I still kept my channel going, took a little break, and, well, yeah, so, just my advice to new YouTubers, or people that have been on YouTube for a while, just, you know, just try not to let the mean comments and stuff like that bother you too much. Just try to kind of move on from it. The next thing I want to talk about is, you know, the one comment that I received the other night kind of struck a chord about me. Oh, you're insecure with your channel because you hide your thumbs up, thumbs down. Okay. The reason I hide the thumbs up, thumbs down is because I feel, now this is my own personal opinion, it's not anybody, it doesn't have to be your opinion, you don't have to believe it or whatever, this is how I feel. I feel when people see that number, it inspires them. And I'm not saying like my regular followers, I'm talking about the trolls and the people that want to be negative. If they see that number affects my channel, I feel that it gives them energy, and I feel that it gives them satisfaction to see, oh, look, I'm the only person that thumbs down his video, or I'm the 10th person that thumbs down his video. So I hide the likes and the dislikes to take that power away. So if they thumbs down my video, they can't see the effect it has on that video. You know what I mean? Like, they can't see if they are the first person to do it, or they're the 10th person, or the 5th, or the 3rd, or the 100th. They can't see that. So, to me, in my mind, I feel like I take a little bit of that power away from them. You know what I mean? Now, if that makes sense, perfect. But that's just how I feel on the thumbs up, thumbs down. I hide them, or I don't display them, to kind of take that power away from those types of people. Okay, next topic and next subject I want to talk about. And like I say, guys, this is just a total random video that I wanted to make. It's late, so I mean, it may not come out as great as I want it to, but just some thoughts I've had on my experience on YouTube, my experience of dealing with trolls, and my experience of dealing with assholes, and of course me being, you know, a negative person at one point in my life, and doing things that I feel that are happening to me now and happened to me in the past, that I feel is sort of like a karma coming back and smacking me in the butt. Friends and people that you thought were your friends on YouTube, they come and go. And I've had a lot of experience with that. I've met a ton of great people on YouTube. There are some really great people out there. There's some really cool people out there. And sometimes people just have differences, and they fall, you know, they just, the relationship kind of falls apart, and they just go separate ways. At one time on YouTube, when I first started, I was kind of popular. I had a lot of YouTube people that, quote-unquote, that I like to call friends. And you just learn over time that people that you thought were your friends on YouTube are just like people in real life that you thought were your friends. They come and go. No one ever stays around forever. I'm not gonna say any YouTubers' names or anything like that, because at the end of the day, who really cares? You know, I've never been one person to dwell on, oh man, you know, I gotta have all this amount of subscribers, I've gotta have this amount of likes, I've gotta have this amount of views. I mean, yeah, it does affect everybody. you know, you want to have, I mean, you'd be lying if you said you didn't want to have, you know, your channel to be successful. Everybody makes videos to be successful at some level or another. I mean, now I've gotten to the point where now, I mean, at first everybody's like that. Everybody's like, I gotta have this. You know, you have a goal set in your head, or a number set in your head. And I remember when I hit 500 subscribers, I was like, wow. I never thought in a million years 500 people in this world would want to watch some random dude from Florida make videos about comic books and, you know, and action figures or sometimes video games. But then you get to a point where you're like, now, and I'm not saying this is for anybody else, but now I just make content for me. I know a lot of people on YouTube, you know, they feel like they have to make now this is just comic book YouTubers. They have to show like these big major keys to get views. And yeah, when you get the big keys, they tend to get more views than to say somebody that's doing a flea market haul or a dollar bin haul or completing a run haul or run filler hauls. Because, you know, I feel like right now on YouTube now, the comic book YouTube community now, seems to be more focused on, like, live videos, auctions, and the big key videos. People want to see big keys. They want to, you know, they want to participate in auctions, which I think the auction videos and the live stream videos, it's pretty awesome. Because, I mean, back when I started, there wasn't a whole lot. There were actually no auction videos at all. There were zero. And there were just a few. Sorry about that. The camera fell. There were just a few. I was getting back to what's on YouTube now. And now there's like live streams and auction videos and talking about key videos and stuff like that. There were no auction videos. So it was weird because, you know, now it's amazing. You can buy books from other collectors. And you know the books have been taken care of. You know, you can actually see what you want. And, like, when I started my live streams back in the day, there were not that many live stream shows. I can remember, you know, there were, like, maybe, including myself, maybe 5 or 6 YouTubers, 7 YouTubers that had live streams. And each one of us basically had, it almost seemed like we each had our own day. I was Friday nights, and my show was called Junkie After Midnight. And, you know, there were other channels that had other shows on other nights of the week. And now it seems like every time you turn on YouTube, there's a live stream. And that's cool. And it's awesome. It's great that part of the community has grown and that there's different types of content that people can watch. And I know the live streams are a big thing now. And it's great because you can just turn on your phone. Or you can turn on your webcam and you can get on and start talking about comics and you can join the chat and stuff like that, and it's great. But getting back to how people come and go from YouTube, there have been channels that I thought were, you know, we were friendly, and then next thing you know, you don't hear from them anymore. And, you know, they don't comment anymore, they don't socialize with you anymore on your channel, and then you check and they find out that they're unsubbed to you. So you're like, okay, well, you know, they're gonna unsub me, then I'll just unsub them, and we'll just go about our days. And, it's weird how people will come and go from your life. You know, one day you think this person is the best person in the world, and you guys are going to be friends forever, and then the next day, you're just not. And they leave your channel for one reason or another. They just don't like you, they don't like your comments, they don't like your videos, whatever the case may be, people just come and go from your life on YouTube. And, you know, it sucks, because you thought they were good friends of yours, and you just come to realize that, and just like in real life, man, people come and go from your life, and you have, they're your friend one day, and then you're not the next. So, there's just so many different types of things you have to deal with, and kind of get used to in YouTube. You know that phrase, nothing lasts forever, and that's 100% true. You could be on top of the world on YouTube one day, and the next day you're down on the bottom. You could have a ton of people that comment and you thought were your friends on YouTube, and then the next day they're all gone. So you just have to learn to roll with the punches, deal with the negativity, and just kind of go about your business. Another thing that is big now is like showing the big keys. Don't feel obligated that you have to, you know, go out and break your bank and buy all these key books just to get views on YouTube. Because remember, at the end of the day, it's just YouTube. These people are here. Most people are just here to watch videos. Some people only want to watch videos that deal with key comics. I've gotten to the point now where I'm more into filling in runs. Like, if you've noticed lately, I've been having a lot of Conan videos on my channel. Because I've just gotten a hair up my ass that I want to collect Conan. I want to complete Conan the Barbarian Volume 1. So I've been buying a bunch of, you know, Conan books. And they're not expensive books. They're dollar books. They're $1.50 books, $1.70 books. There's some big books, but I haven't gotten those yet. So most of the videos I've been showing have been run fillers. And most people don't want to watch that type of video. But, you know, those, the type of videos that I put out now, like my weekly LCS haul videos, or I'll do an eBay haul video, and once in a while I'll do what's in the box video. And the what's in the box videos tend to be my, the what's in the box videos and contest videos tend to be the lowest viewed videos on my channel. My how-to videos or stuff like that tend to get the most views. So you can always tell what kind of content people want to see. But at the end of the day, you have to make content for yourself. You have to make the kind of videos you want to make, because trying to keep up with the Joneses and having key videos all the time, A, you're going to break the bank, and B, it's not something you can keep up all the time. And then what happens is people that start out on YouTube and feel like they have to make videos that are focused strictly on key books or big boy books, you're going to tend to burn yourself out, because you know, you may not be able to afford but maybe one or two or three keys a month. And, you know, you'll have one video a month and you're showing three books and you'll get a ton of views, but then all of a sudden your views just drop off. So you have to make content that you enjoy. And, I mean, for those people that can go out and get keys all the time, hey, good for them. That's awesome. I spend way too much money on my weekly hauls. My weekly LCS hauls range from anywhere from $80 to $100 to $120 a week. Because I just have so much shit on my pull list. And, you know, I could just say, fuck it, and only get three or four books a week. And use that rest of the money and buy, I could buy a big key every week, you know, or a couple keys a week. But that's not the direction my collection's in right now. But that could change, you know, that could change in a month. In a month, I could be like, I just want to focus on key books and not have a pull list. But I'm doing a lot of rambling here, so I appreciate you guys sticking with me if you're watching this video. But yeah, just, you got to make content that you enjoy, and you have to get to a point where, like, you have to get to a point in your mind where you're like, okay, if I make a video and it only gets 30 views or 50 views or 100 views, are you okay with that? You know what I mean? Don't think that every video you make has to be a 1,000 view video or a 500 view video, you know, just if you, once you get out of that mindset, then you'll be okay. Like, I've moved on, and you know, my videos, I used to get 400, 500, 600 views a video. Now I'm to the point where I get a couple hundred, you know, if it's a good video, you know, the first month I might get 300, 400 views, and over time it'll pick up, and then I'll go back and look at a video that I made 3 months ago, and it'll have 1,000 views. And I'm like, wow, okay, that's pretty good. Because I've come to terms with the content that I put out, not everybody is going to enjoy. Not everybody's going to like. You just have to put up content that you enjoy. And if 5 people like it, awesome. If 100 people like it, even better. If 1,000 people like it, man, that's awesome. But you have to do it for you, because once you start making videos for other people, you'll get burnt out, and you'll get bitter, and you'll start to regret that, you know, you made content that you didn't really enjoy. I love every video that I put out now. It's, even though it's just a weekly haul, or it's a what's in the box, or it's a small eBay haul of books that no one even gives a shit about, I don't care, I like it. And if 10 people like it, awesome. So, yeah, I know this video is kind of all over the place, and, it's gonna get some hate, it's gonna get thumbs down, it's gonna get, oh man, Junkie, you know, you're an asshole, and I don't like you because of this, and that's fine. People are allowed to have their opinions of me, and I'm allowed to have my opinions of them, And I'm not going to come on here and say I'm holier than thou, because I've made mistakes and I've done stupid shit on YouTube. And you just got to learn to roll with the punches and accept if you've been a mean person in the past, you just have to accept what's coming to you. But I'm not going to put up with stupid comments about personal jabs at me, or just really like weird comments. Now, I'm not gonna have that on my channel. Is my voice a little, you know, I'm getting complaints about my voice. Yeah, my voice is a little different. Don't know what it is, just the way it is. Either you like it or you don't. If you don't like it, then don't watch my channel. Am I heavy? Yeah, I'm a little bit overweight, but I'm almost 50 years old, and who cares? You know what I mean? If you're upset and you dislike my channel because of my weight or my voice, then that's on you, man. That ain't on me. I'm good. I'm married. My wife's beautiful, and I'm good. So obviously it bothers you more than it bothers me. And to the people, I mean, some of the people that I thought were my friends that are no longer involved with my channel, not even a comment or hey man, how you doing, or anything like that. Kind of shocked at some of them. I thought we were cool, but that's just the way it goes. You know, I've, like I said in earlier in the video, I've never been a big person on having like a lot of friends. I don't need a lot of people in my life. I don't need to have a ton of friends. So when people come and go that were friends of mine on YouTube, some of them, I'm like, wow, you know, I thought we were pretty tight, you know, and then I just move on from it. I don't dwell on it, and I know I'm making a video, and people are like, well, you are kind of dwelling on it. I'm just kind of making this video to help people that have commented to me privately about how do I deal with certain things. So this is why I'm making this video. And it's just my thoughts on certain things on YouTube. You know, YouTube doesn't always have to be, you don't always have to put out content about comics or video games or how to plant, you know, garden or anything like that. You can make random videos on your channel. It's your channel. You do with it what you want. And let me see if there's anything else I want to kind of touch on. So I've touched on trolls. How do I deal with, you know, trolls of, how do I deal with people that come and go friend-wise on YouTube? I've dealt with that. told you guys that I'm not perfect. I've made mistakes in the past, man. I've made a ton of mistakes. But you try to grow from it and move on from it. And, you know, like my how... a couple months back, I made some how-to videos, like how to open a comic book box, how to put a comic book in a bag and board. Every now and then, the asshole in me comes out, and I saw a YouTuber make a video about, I don't even remember what it was even about, but he's pretty popular on YouTube now, and, I made some parody videos, and I thought they were funny. They got some good laughs out of people. I got a few thumbs down, but people need to just be kind of like, get a little bit of thicker skin, man. If I make a video about how to open a comic book box with two fingers, it's a fucking joke. People just need to quit thinking that everything everybody makes is so serious. It is, at the end of the day, it's about comic books. Comic books, people. So there's no reason to get so defensive, so offended. It is comic books at the end of the day. We're grown adults, most of us are grown adults, men and women, that collect comic books, that collect action figures that are basically toys, collect pop figures, we collect video games. So at the end of the day, just remember that and realize it's a hobby for fun. And some people get so mad and so offended over other people's content. It's just crazy. And another thing I'm going to hit on, and some people are going to think this is an asshole content, but if you see YouTubers that have 5,000, 6,000 subscribers and they make comic book content, just know those numbers they're not real numbers. It's not a real number. It's not, you know, there's ways on YouTube that you can pay for subscribers. And now some people are going to think, oh, he's being an asshole. He's bashing certain YouTubers. I'm not naming names. I'm not bashing anybody. Hey, if you want to pay for subscriptions, that's up to you. You know, you can do that. I want people to realize you can do that. Just look at the number of subscribers compared to the number of comments on videos. If a video has 10,000 views, but it only has 50 comments, do the math. It's not a legit number. It's not a legit number. Now some YouTubers that have been around for years, I'm talking like 8, 9, 10 years, and they have 4,000, and they have 5,000 subs. That is possibly a legit... it's a legit number. But people that have been around for a year or two and have like 10,000, 7,000 subs, that's not a real number. It's not a real number. Like my number, 2,400 subs. Not all of them are active. So, you know, in my... like I said, I have 2,400 subs, and I only get a couple hundred views, 300-400 views a video. A lot of them channels are dead channels or channels of people that had made content years ago that just don't make content anymore. You can check on them. You can click on somebody's link and look and see that they made videos 3-4 years ago or 2 years ago. It's the ones when you click on their channel and they have no content. You know, so just be wary of that. So, and the reason I mention that is because I feel like people, when they start out on YouTube, and they're like, man, my subscriber base isn't growing, I only have 100 subs, or I only have 200 subs, or I only have 400 subs, but Joe, and you know, Joe Blow down on the other end of YouTube has 7,000 subs, and he's been here just as long as me. Just know that as long as your channel is growing consistently, you're doing okay. And make content for yourself, and know that there are ways out there that you can buy subscribers. You pay a monthly fee, and a company will feed you and give you subscribers. and some of them are people, are real people, and they just, they get paid to subscribe to channels, and they get paid to leave comments or whatever. So don't get discouraged if you and Billy down the street have made the YouTube channel the same time, and they're now at 3,000 subs, and you're only at 200 subs. Just know, Billy down the street may have paid $50 to get 2,000 subs. But I think that's about it. If anybody wants me to talk about or ramble about any other topics related to comics or action figures, mainly comics, you know, just leave a comment down below. I may hold comments for this video for my approval, and that's another thing. There are tools on YouTube that will help you control the way people view your channel. You can control it to where it doesn't seem like it's you know, people get a negative view of your channel, aka hiding your likes and dislikes. I like I said, I do it to take control away from the trolls. You can make it to where you have to approve the comments before they're posted, or you can just make a video where there's comments are just not allowed. It's your channel, you do what you want. Like I said, I like videos that show runs, show run fillers, dollar books, because to me, that's I like that. I like key issue videos too, but I don't want to watch just all key issue videos. You know what I mean? So make the content you want. Don't worry about trolls. Just remember, you know, if you fuck up on YouTube and you've done some things that offended people and you've lost friends over it, just know, hey, you know, in a year or two, the friends you lost will be replaced with new friends. There's been YouTubers that I thought were my friends that I've lost, and I've lost a lot of people that I thought were really good friends, and I've gained some really good friends, you know, over the years. But that's about it. So leave your comments, leave your concerns, and maybe I'll make another one of these videos soon. But that's about it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it gave you a little bit of insight onto who I am, in the way I do things and the way that I handle certain situations here on YouTube. I hope this helps. And it's the Junkie, and it's a late night video, and I am out. Peace.